What do you make of this uncertainty, and are you concerned about this, a possible government instability?
I think, you know, after the general election yesterday, the key political parties will, you know, must be very busy, you know, forming the coalition government. So the more stable of the coalition government, the better impact to the Thai economy.
But given that there's no majority, what would it mean for policies? It can either be just pro-junta coalition or a democratic coalition, but no majority.
I think, you know, in every political parties, they have almost the same economy policy, you know, the way. So no matter what the government will be, I believe that the economy policy from any kind of combination will be the same. And because of the fundamental, despite of the political environment, I believe that the fundamental Thailand economy will be still sound, driven by the consumption economy, export, and also the tourism.
Fundamentals are sound, but it is losing its competitiveness. In fact, it's lost its competitiveness when it comes to being a manufacturing hub. What policies would you like to see in place for Thailand going forward?
I think, you know, the underserved, the unbanked, that we need to focus on, because the upper segment, they're already doing well. So if we can, you know, focus on the underserved segment, that will stimulate the consumption and the overall Thailand economy.
What does it mean for the banking sector then?
So meaning that we have to also focus the unbanked segment, focus on the segment that we never do business with before, we have to understand them more by using the big data, the more robust credit risk management, and, you know, new way of doing the customer acquisition.
And you've tied up with players like Line, for instance, to upgrade in terms of technology. Do you see more such partnerships going forward?
Yeah, I think, you know, banking have to be wherever customer goes. So we want to embed it in the customer life and in any step of the way. So, you know, when they transport, when they commute, they want to buy coffee, they do the online shopping, we have to be there. So any kind of partnership that's relevant, that make KBank or any bank relevant to the customer life, that will be, you know, new way of business model.
The former CEO of Citibank has come up to say that he expects 1 million jobs in the banking sector to disappear over the next 5 years. Will that happen, or to what extent will that happen in Thailand?
Yeah, right now we still see the cash transaction growing in a one-digit, you know, percent growth. However, we also see the digital transaction growing like, you know, 100-200%. So I believe within 3 to 5 years there will be more on the cashless society.
Would that mean a lot of jobs in the banking sector here?
No, I think it's a new way of working that, you know, the bankers have to work different way. And, you know, every bank and the government still, I think we need to, you know, work together to reskill our Thai people, you know, to be able to ready for the new era.
When you take a look at the banking industry, we're seeing, for instance, a pending merger involving TMB. Are we on the verge of a consolidation within the Thai banking industry?
As far as I know, that's the only deal I know. But there might be some, you know, partnership working with other corporate, you know, in a different industry. Like I just said, is like, you know, we want to be in other ecosystem to stay relevant to our customers.
So it means partnership with tech companies, startups?
Yes.
Is that something Kaskan Bank is looking at as well?
Yes.
And
yes.
What can we expect over the next 12, 24, 36 months, for instance?
Okay. Working with the Line, the transportation also like, you know, including gas, some e-commerce kind of thing.